That's it. We're going to see Buckeye Furnace.
Would you look at that? That's pretty daggone neat. I cannot believe I didn't know this is here.
Walking a mile. I mean, you walk up in Pepco so far, but
we'll check this place out.
This far, but up there's locked.
What do you mean up there's locked? How you know?
I'm in here, dog.
This is neat. This is really.
The road goes all the way up, and they give you a tour.
That is so. Oh, okay. Is it? You got to pay for the tour? Pretty. Pretty amazing. Wow, wow.
Well, here's
part. I don't know if you can tell, but that's huge. That whole structure is. Look up back here. I will. I'm going to look back here real quick. Oh, you can do a loop. Oh, my goodness. Ah, what a shame you can't see this like I can. It's a shame. It's really, really cool. I really like this. Can't believe I've never heard of this place before. Something's creepy. Is that you making that noise?
What?
Trying to scare me?
It will.
Uh-huh.
Good.
Yeah, sure. So let me ask you this. You've been here before and walked the grounds.
Well, I didn't knock that down before.
What's that doing? What's that doing that for? Why is that turn? What's that do?
I don't know. That came.
I see that. That's a big old stinking wheel. My goodness, what's it say? Shipment of iron. The shipment of pig iron was a continual problem at Buckeye Furnace. When Buckeye Furnace was constructed, the owners planned to ship the iron on small boats down the Little Raccoon Creek. After predictable water levels in the stream made this method of shipping impractical, the furnace owners turned to wagons. Teamsters transported the iron to the railroad at Berlin Crossroads, 3 miles away. Where are you going?
You like the one.
Oh, that's probably my fault. Probably my fault. This place is. What's that? What's the light up there? 18, what did I say? It's closed down. 18, what was it? 1894? I think it closed down. While the iron was cooling, the patterns formed by the molds and channels on the casting house floor resembled a sow of nursing piglets. Because of this resemblance, the iron taken from the models referred to as pig iron. Each pig was 4 feet long, 4 inches wide, and 6 inches deep. I did not know that's why they called it pig iron. That's interesting. Interesting. Here, I'm just going to do this right here, and you can pause it if you want to see anything else. If you need to know any more info, all you can do is hit that pause button, and that way it's not taking me the whole time to read it. And if it's something like, hey, that's interesting, you can read it. Oh. You know, it looks like I'm going fast. I'm kind of trying to go reasonably fast because I'm getting along. Look at that big old fireplace. My goodness, that thing's big. See, on each side, I've done been outside. You've seen it. There's little vent-looking things on each side. I'm not sure exactly what that is about. It's just the air to keep it moving or what. That is really interesting. Okay. The doors are unlocked, so it looks like we can check it out.
So,
huh? This door's unlocked and opened. It's getting dark. Oh, it's neat. Oh, it's cool. I'm not sure what I'm looking at. I don't know what that is. Huh? I'd like to go in that. What about the one up top? How would you get there?
You gotta go to where our house is. That driveway goes down on
What's this guy doing? Here comes somebody. Here he comes. What are they doing? He went by awful slow. So we can't get up there. That is a major stinky bummer. What's up in that building? What? There's got. I don't want it blocked off. I don't want to hear negative. I want to hear answers. Answers, I tell you, is what I want. Oh, it's an engine house. Must have been steam powered. The conversion of iron ore into molten iron required very high temperature, y'all. To raise the temperature, compressed air was pumped into the furnace. A steam engine located in this building. This building. Turned a 15-foot flywheel that operated two large blowing tubs, pistons, y'all, located inside. So, there's the blowing. Where is that? Is that thing in there? The blowing tub? Is there a blowing tub in there? That thing's hooked too. Let's see it. Should be a blowing tub, they're calling it. You say they're still working on it then?
Well, see here. You see what
it is? Yeah, okay. All right, all right, all right. Is this the original structure you're saying?
This is, but
okay. It's in pretty good shape if it's the original structure.
As far as I know, it's original.
As far as we know. This place is such a beautiful piece of history. Good grief. Look at the rock. Look at them big old things. It's amazing what you can do when you set your mind to it. Look at that. And like the big old beam they got right here. That big old, look at that big beam right there. It's just on a big old, like a sandstone. I'm assuming that's sandstone. It's just like a big old, well, furnace. I guess that's why I call it Buckeye Furnace. That makes sense. Yeah, it's a big furnace, ain't it? Big old chimney. That says something up there. What's that say? Oh, it says Buckeye Furnace. Is that 1856? Can't quite tell. Not quite sure. Buckeye Furnace. What does that say? I might be able to zoom in later, but I can't really tell. All right, I guess. The puppy dog followed me. Keep an eye on the place. I don't know why they wouldn't let you up there, but it don't matter what I think. It's really neat.
And I do appreciate you guys. If you stuck it out the whole time and watched it, that's pretty awesome of you. And I do appreciate it. And this vlog is done.